These shots are not CGI, and they only took minutes. Now, they are not full CGI quality, but here's the thing. For the most marketing use cases, you just don't need that level. This workflow that I built gives you that cinematic, gigantic size of your product feel in a fraction of a time. And it works basically with no technical setup and with significantly smaller budget. And even though it won't give you that CGI precision and accuracy, it will get you 80% there, and most of the time it's enough. So let me show you how I exactly did it. In my case, I worked on my most favorite bar, which is this one. The only thing you need is a photo of it. So this is how my workflow looks like. You'll find the link to this workflow for free, but of course I will clean it up for you. This one is a bit messy. However, I will walk you through it and how does it work. Basically, the only thing you need in the beginning is the photo of the product. To get the visual, you can take a couple of approaches. You can let it generate just with one image, as I did in here. Or you can have a couple of images of that same product with different angles if you would want to capture also a backside. Or you can do the very same thing with multiple shots. You would just stitch them together, Photoshop or anywhere else, and you have one big image with multiple shots. In every single case, it works just fine, and I will show you that, because this line on the top is made with the prompt, which is basically the most important part here to get the prompt right, with one image. Then I have same model, which is Nano Banana, but I plugged in six images, and the third one is again the same prompt, but I plugged in only one image with multiple angles. Again, if you want to try it or do just the simple version, you just use one image and you are basically done and prepared. And what is most valuable on this workflow is this prompt right here, which is kind of a longer one, but it contains those important tokens that gives you that big look. Otherwise, the product might look big, but not of a building size, let's say. So if you would be using that, you don't need to change a single thing in here. You just plug it there, because I actually wrote its product and referenced image, which should cover most of the cases. In certain scenarios, you can just rewrite that part and maybe to specify what it actually is. But even if you would not do that, it should work just fine. So keep this prompt untouched, or maybe specify the product if you want. It's not necessary. And we will use Nano Banana. We will plug the prompt in and image or images here, which will give us most of the time great results. There are of course some bad generations, but since it's AI, it happens. However, most of them are super cool. You can just take a look. In every single one, the product looks good enough. This one is kind of interesting because the bar is levitating above. It's not placed on any building. However, no matter which one it was, it actually worked most of the time. And also in here, this one, which is kind of a vertical placement of the bar, is one of the one I like most. And once you have your image ready, you can start to generate your videos out of it. If your main use for that would be social media reels, then I would advise to let it generate 9x16 portrait version right from the beginning. You can get much better results with it than just to maybe let it outpaint. It's completely unnecessary work, but in my case I was working with landscape version, and in here I have again prepared prompt for you where you have like aerial orbit shot around giant product on a skyscraper, let's say, camera circling smoothly to the right, you can rewrite to the left or do whatever you want. And product is fixed on its place, only camera moves. You can change it, it's completely up to you, but this one is kind of a safe bet and most of the time it works super cool. For this version I used Seedance, which is one of my most favorite models, and it's also significantly cheaper than, let's say, VO3, which I will also use, but let's not spend credits where it's not necessary. And here you can see that we have our shot done also. In here, in every scenario, it turns right, just as I prompted. Just this one maybe is doing a little bit different motion, but it happens, and still I actually really like it. And it was this time where I somehow ideate that it might be cool to have a shot where you have a time lapse and daytime turns into night, which I again tried with Seedance, but I just got a couple of standard generations. However, I'm saying from my experience that if you want a time-lapse video, VO 3.1 is a way to go, because for this purpose it is really cool and gives you a great result. We can take a look at it, or maybe just get back to it where I only changed a prompt a little bit. I added that it's time-lapse and I use that twice in the prompt, so it somehow gets the point that it is the case. Otherwise it might maybe miss it. And I also added that the shot turning daylight scene into the night scene, which is again important token for the model to know what it should generate. And you can take a look in here. Actually, this one is the best I got out of whole workflow, and it was done on the very first try, so super cool. I don't need audio, but VO3 gives you that. We can take a look here also. A bit different approach, but it gets darker. And let's say also here. This one is really interesting. I like that yellow color at the end. And this is basically it. I can show you a quick example with other bar where I generated again a placement of gigantic bar on the building, used same prompt here and got back these cool videos. It's square version here, landscape version here. And for those that would like to see it in real time, I will do that and show it to you. So we can use, for example, this product. I can simply copy it and paste it here. And with this product, only thing I need is this prompt, which I will copy because I don't want to drag those lines, so it will be too cluttered. And I will bring in Nano Banana, where I will plug the prompt in, image in, and for this case, I can maybe show you 9x16. So we will go portrait mode. And in here, I could maybe rewrite its monument-sized bag of chips. And it should work fine. In here, I can maybe let it do 4 rounds right from the start. So let's hit. And while this is being generated, I can go here and copy prompt and Seedance, or I can copy just this one and I will bring a clean Seedance there. Let's paste it here and we are already done. We have cool shots. I actually don't like this one, it's too flat. However, this look super cool. I'm really happy with it. So I will bring Seedance here. I can switch to Pro, plug in the image, plug in the prompt, And if you would like maybe to add something special that a helicopter will fly in or whatever, just prompt it there. But for this case, I will just hit run. And now let's just wait. Same here, I will do Veo 3.1 here, and I will copy the prompt with time-lapse version, which is here. I will plug image here, I will plug my prompt here. Let's turn it to 9x16. And in this case, I don't need audio. Let's use fast version and we can hit run. Now, the Seedance version is done and it looks beautiful. I actually like that those billboards are showing something. Maybe I could just add into a prompt that those billboards will present like yellow colored ad of that product. It might work or it might not just as well, but however, this is the nature of AI. You just need to experiment and find a way. And now let's wait for Veo. And we are done here also. Let's check. And it's getting dark. I'm completely happy. And if we take a look, let's say with one image and one video generated with Seedream, if I select this part and skip the Veo 3, it costs you like 92 credits if you hit it on the first run. So maybe add a couple of credits to generate 3 or 4 images until you are fine with it. Let's say you still will be around 100 credits, which is equivalent of $1, I guess. But if you take a look at it, it looks super cool. You can, of course, upscale it, no problem. And as we said before, the level of quality won't compare to the 3D render, but this is not the case of maybe fighting with it. AI would never win. But just as well, smaller brands or individuals that do not have 3D background would never be able to get these types of results for their products. So I think it might be kind of a win-win. So to wrap it up, if you would want to try it, I'm sharing the whole workflow in the comments for free. Use it, tweak it, break it, improve it. I welcome all of that. And for now, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.